friends, how are you all? Today we are going to learn a new exercise, that is 2.3. Let's see question number 1. It says, divide the following polynomial px by the polynomial gx and find the quotient, that is qx, and remainder rx. So the first question given is px and gx. So in px, it says, x cube minus 3x square plus 5x minus 3, and for gx, x square minus 2. Before solving this question, we must learn some new points, some important points, that we have to observe the question very properly, and all the degrees of the term must be in descending order. Here in px, the higher degree is 3, then 2, then 1, and then without variable. This is proper. This is the proper way of writing a polynomial. But in gx, if you observe that x square is there, but term x is missing. So you can add 0x, because by multiplying it with 0, this term will have no value. Yes, man. So we can add 0x or any other term that is missing with 0 coefficient. Yes, next we do long division method that you have already learned in 9th standard. So in the concept, you write down the values, then how to divide it. See, the first term of dividend and first term of divisor, that we will take and we will divide the first term of dividend with first term of divisor. So the remainder is x. This x is the first quotient, first term of quotient. Understood, friend? Now this x will multiply with the divisor, all the terms of divisor, and that we will write downward here. Understood? See, multiply with this x into x square, that is x cube, 0x square, that is 0x square, and 2 into x, that is 2x, 1 minus is there, so minus sign. Now, you know, we do the subtraction here. So by changing all the sign of this, we will have these terms, and this 3 we will take downward. Now again we will repeat this process. The first term of this dividend will divide it by the first term of divisor, that is x square. So x square will cancel, you will have minus 3. So this minus 3 is the second term of your quotient. Understood, friend? Now again we do the subtraction, and whatever the remains are there, that is our remainder. So your quotient is here and your remainder is here. So that you will write this way. Now solve the next question. Next question, also you must observe the question first. Yes, friend. Here x raised to 4 is given. So after 4, there must be a term that will have a degree 3. But that is not there. Directly degree 2 is given. So we can add that term this way. Understood, friend? Now again see, 2 after that 1. Yes, they are in sequence. So we will write it as it is. Now here for gx, you will observe that highest degree is 2, that is given. Then 1 is also given, degree 1 is also given, but they are not in sequence. So you write them in sequence like this. Yes, friend. Now these are our polynomials. Now we will divide px with gx. The same process we will repeat here also. The first term of our dividend is divided by first term of our divisor, so that will give you x square. So x square is the first term of your quotient. Now this x square, we multiply all the term of divisor, so we will have this number. Now again we will do the subtraction, and the extra terms we will take it down. Now again for the next term in coefficient, we must divide this term with x square. So you know, x cube divided by x square will give you x. So this x will again multiply with divisor, all the term of divisor, and we will get this value. Again we will do the subtraction. Again
the first term of this divisor, dividend, is divided by the first term of divisor. So you see x square is there, again x square is there, they will divide, so only minus 3 will remain, so that is our third term of quotient. So from this 3 we will multiply all the terms of divisor, so we will have this term. By subtracting we will have 8 as our remainder. So our quotient is this and remainder is this. Yes friends, so we have learned how to solve a polynomial, division of polynomial by long division method. Let's take another question, that is our question number 2 of exercise 2.3. Yes friend, now it says check whether the first polynomial is the factor of the second polynomial by dividing the second polynomial by the first polynomial. So here in the question we have given two polynomials, that is gt and pt. Yes friend, gt is given t square minus 3 and pt is given 2t raised to 4 plus 3t raised to 3 minus 2t raised to 2 minus 9t minus 12. This way. Here also we have to see the question very properly so that we may know that there is a term, missing term. Now we can also solve this kind of question without adding the term. But you must pay attention how I am going to solve this. See, the first term of this dividend is divided by the first term of the divisor. So 2t raised to 4 will divide it by 2 square t square. So we will have here 2t square. That is the first term of our quotient. Now this first term of quotient will multiply with these two terms. So t2 raised to 2 will multiply t square will give you t 2t raised to 4. Yes friend. Now if we multiply, do the multiplication of 3 into 2 raised to 2t raised to 2, so you will have 6t square. So in the term, in this polynomial will lie this term, because this is t square only, so under t square we will write it. This place will be vacant, we will write nothing in this place because we need like terms. We can solve the like terms. So we, by multiplying this term with minus 3, we are having 6 minus 6 t square, so we will write it under t square only. Yes friend, now we do the minus here, so this t cube will comes as it is. We will solve it, then we will have 4 t square, then these two terms we will take down. Now again the first term of this dividend will be divided by the first term of divisor, so t 3t cube divided by t square will give you 3t. So we will like take it here, second term of quotient. Now multiplying with this we will have this, but we remember we must write the term under the like terms only. So this place will be vacant here. Now we will solve it. So now this term will eliminate each other, so we will have two terms here. So the first term, that is 4t square, will be divided by the first term of dividend. So 4 is the answer. This is the third term of our quotient. Now this 4 will be multiplied with these terms, so we will have this. And by subtracting we will have 0, so no remainder is there. If in the quotient there is no remainder, remainder is 0, then the second term, first term is the factor of the second polynomial. First polynomial is the factor of the second polynomial. Same way we are going to solve second quotient. Gx is given. See, x cube is given and after that directly x is given. So now we can add another term, the missing term, that is x square with coefficient 0. For second polynomial, x raised to 5, x raised to 3, x raised to 2, x raised to 1. Is there any missing term friends? Yes. 0, x raised to 4 we have to add, that is the missing term. X raised to 4 is the missing term. Yes friend, now we will do the division here as we did in the earlier questions. So here we are getting remainder, that is 2. After solving the question. If there is remainder, so it is not the factor. Gx is not the factor of Px. First polynomial is not the factor of Px.
Hi friends, let's solve another very important question from exam point of view. That is question number 3 of exercise 2.3. The question says, obtain all other zeros of this polynomial if two zeros of it are 5 by 3 whole root in minus. So this polynomial is having higher degree, that is 4. So this polynomial must have 4 solutions, 4 zeros. So 2 of them is given. So zeros means a value of x. So we will take x equal to first value and x equal to second value. Understood, friend? Now take these values with x. So it will form x minus whole under root 5 by 3 equal to 0 and x plus 5 by 3 whole root equal to 0. Now we will do the multiplication on left hand side. So on right hand side also 0 into 0 will become 0. Here you can see an identity rule of factorization is applied. That is a minus b, a plus b equal to a square minus b square. So by applying this identity rule, we can say x square minus 5 by 3 whole root square. So by solving, we will have this value. This we will termed as gx. This was our first step. In first step, we have to find out gx. That is the divisor. Now, we have to do long division method in step 2. And how we can do that? So the polynomial given to us is divided by this term that we have found out. By doing long division method, we will have our question this. You can solve long division method because we have seen many videos on that. So this is our quotient. This we will take in next step, that is step 3. We will do the factorization of this gx. So this gx equal to 0 we will take. Now splitting middle term method that we have seen in our videos. We will have x plus 1 is 0 and x plus 1 is 0. So now this 1 will take other side. So our two zeros will be minus 1, minus 1. So our answer is other two zeros are minus 1 and minus 1. Now take another example, another question, question number 4. It says on dividing this px by a polynomial gx, the quotient and the remainder were x minus 2 and minus 2x plus 4. So the first one is quotient and second one is remainder. Now do another example first. Let's say we divide 7 with 2. So, you know, 3, 2, 6 we will write, that is 1. Now how can you write 7? See, we can write 2 into 3 plus 1. That will be our answer 7. Now what is 7 exactly? 7 is the px. 7 is the px. This 2 is the divisor. So we will take it as gx. This 3 is your quotient. So we will take it qx. So we will do multiplying in that between them. And this 1 is the remainder. So we will take rx. So this is our formula to solve that question. So now I have written the same formula over here. Now you come to know how we derive this formula. This is not a new thing. Okay friends. Now we substitute the value of px, gx we have to find out, qx and rx. Now you open the bracket. So 2x plus 4 will remain. Now this 2x plus 4 will come other side of equal to, and it will change its sign. And this term x minus 2 is within multiply with gx, so it will come to denominator for division. We will solve that numerator. After solving that, we will have x cube minus 3x square plus 3x minus 2 divided by x minus 2. Now this x minus 2, we divide this numerator with long division method. So we have seen many of our long division method. So now this part you have to solve your own. Whatever the quotient is there, that is your gx for the answer.